AI systems are already being integrated into the construction industry. Innovative practices such as computational architecture are working with robotic craftsmen to explore AI in construction technology and fabrication. Michael Hansmeier and Benjamin Dillenberger, founders of computational architecture, are investigating the new aesthetic language these technological developments are starting to generate. 3D printing technology developed from AI software has the potential to offer 21st century architects a significantly different aesthetic language, perhaps catalyzing a resurgence of detail and ornamentation, now rare due to the decline in traditional crafts. Hansmeier and Dillenberger's grotto prototype for the Supermaterial exhibition in London was a complex architectural grotto 3D printed from sandstone. The form of the sand grains was arranged by a series of algorithms custom designed by the practice. The technique allowed forms to be developed which were significantly different to that of traditional stone masonry. The aim of the project was to show that it is now possible to print building scale rooms from sandstone and that 3D printing can also be used for heritage applications, such as repairs to statues. AI robots are also becoming more common on construction sites. According to the Association of Equipment Manufacturers, their applications will soon expand to bricklaying, concrete dispensing, welding, and demolition. Another example of their future use could include working with BIM to identify missing elements in the snagging process and provide updates in real time. Large-scale projects, for example, government-led infrastructure initiatives, might be the first to apply this technology, followed by mid-scale projects in the private sector, such as cultural buildings. The challenges of the construction site will bring AI robotics out of the indoor, sanitized environment of the lab, and into a less scripted reality. Click the top left screen to continue and discover how AI systems are being integrated into the built environment, or go back to parts 1, 2 or 3.